All right, we're back on the Seymour Dam bike route. It's about 12:30 p.m. Just did this one a few days ago, and so I'm not filming most of it. I just want to film Spur 4, which is the route we're going to go on. So we're going to be taking a right turn at Hydraulic Creek to take us through that alien forest, which was on the last video, down to the viewpoint. From there, continuing down till we get to the bridge that X-Files was filmed at, which was also in the last video, and then we're going to take Spur 4 from there, all the way up to the dam. So that'll be a nice side trip, and hopefully we'll see some bears, because they have been spotted around there. There's still a bear warning out here. Well, we've not seen any wildlife on this path other than moths, butterflies, a couple of birds. So I should have brought my jacket this time. It was cool when I started. Now I've warmed up. Taking the hill up in North Van, I was at 90% or something. 10% battery drop. 90 to 80% just going up the hill. So it's dropping pretty fast. I don't get the life of the measure battery, which is a 20 AH. Her bike is still at 100%, doing the exact same trip. I mean, I'm at about 22 kilometers right now, and I'm already down to 68. Those hers tends to drop faster once it drops. And her bike developed a squeak last trip, so I started tightening up things and oiling things. Still hasn't got rid of it, so I'm afraid it might have to be a bike shop repair, and I hate that. The only thing I can try now is taking off the crank and seeing if there's some oiling needed. It's only when you do the pedals forward, not on reverse. And it's not the pedals. It's something in the crank. So yeah, always something. Mine's still okay. Another thing I noticed comparing the Leisure to this RX Pro is that I took the Leisure out to the shop, and well, we're going right here. My setting 1 on the RX Pro for pedal assist is equal to her setting 4. That's the difference. And power. Like, I rarely go out of 1. With hers, One felt like it wasn't doing anything. Two felt like nothing. Three, I barely felt something. And then four, I was getting about the same boost as I would on this bike at one. So this is the forest that was used in the Star Trek movie Beyond, which came out 2016. When I first went through here, I said, wow, this is very alien-like. It'd be good for a movie. Got home, happened to watch Star Trek because it was on TV, and there's a scene popping up from this forest. And I looked up the credits, and it was filmed in Vancouver. I mean, tons of things are filmed in Vancouver. The bridge that we're going to be at is the one where X-Files filmed, and Revenant did a scene right under the bridge where I think they were carrying a body across the river. At least today you're getting a little bit brighter view of this path. Which has a few speed stops, like here. The last time we came out here, there was a lot of smoke still. It was just about 3 days ago. I mean, look at these trees. Isn't that amazing? So yeah, the wildfire smoke has finally passed. That was over a week we had it. Really bad, and it's the worst it's ever been. I mean, it's been starting in the last few years that we would get like a couple days coming up from Washington, Oregon, California, but now it's going to be a yearly thing. So we immediately bought a air purifier and running this thing all day at home. But you know, we'd been sitting around for 5 days, had to get out. I was so sick of it sitting at home, so we finally got out the other day in a week, and there was like nobody up here. And she's taking her time, as usual. I don't know. I guess I'll just wait. That's not normal. Do I have to go back up? She's walking the bike or what? Okay. Yeah. Ah, I can feel some sun. That's a first. I'll have a nicer view from here. Something's loose on my bike. What is it? Handlebars. Handlebars loose. I can feel it. I gotta tighten that up somehow. My handlebar's loose.
Handlebar?
Yeah. I don't know. Let's see. Take one with me. Check out that view. Yeah, much nicer today than a few days ago. It was just gray. Actually getting some sun for the first time in over a week. So yeah, some of the shows they film up here. MacGyver, Jumanji, X-Files, Supernatural, The 100, The Revenant. Yeah, there's a whole list of them on the sign over there. Sort of a base hub. Are you riding down or walking? Really? Just go slow and go through these things. See, my bike battery's probably up again. 76. It always recovers. I got a bit of a squeak on that front brake. Not too bad, but it's there. I like this kind of trail, where the leaves are just hitting you in the face. Mm-hmm. right. So this is a fisherman's area. Somebody's turned the sign. Why? Why would they turn the sign? The gate is actually down now. It's like somebody moved it. Interesting. But this is the place where you need to be bear aware. So she's still got that squeak coming from the pedals or the crank. So trying to figure out what that is, it's going to be the problem. Just ordered an 8mm hex tool so that I can take the cranks off and then maybe see if they need some grease. And if that doesn't work, I don't know. Because her motor is not even in the middle, it's in the back. All right. So I had to tighten up my handlebars. They were a little bit loose. It's good I bought the tool. There's a nice swamp area here on the left. I'm sure they could do some filming for a show here as well. That's a nice shot. Getting some sun on the mountain. Need to do a panorama here. That's what I'm gonna do. This is called Spur 4, and this will take us to Seymour Dan, which you can normally use the normal bike route on a paved road. But I got a better chance of seeing something in here. Thank you. It's quite a drop down to the left. What's this one?
Check that out.
I think we need to go right. Yeah. Oh, wait a sec. No, this takes a little lake. There's a little lake this way.
There's a really mean hill there. You see that?
Where?
Going this way.
Yeah, but this is CRC. It goes to a lake. I don't know.
Yeah, so we continue.
And then it continues back to the Spur 4. I don't know. You want to see it?
No.
Well, there's a lake. So, what do we have the bikes for? Oh, nice hill. No kidding. All the way to gear one. Cheater. Stay in assist one and try it. Nice drop there. Full throttle right in there. Come on. Good for you too. Full throttle. is our route. Yeah, not that much farther. But we can go a little bit beyond too. Oh, I'm sure I'm fine. It's at most 3 kilometers. I'm amazed if you look up Spur 4 on YouTube, there isn't a single video of this trail. Right in my face, that moth. I thought there would be lots of videos of this, and there's nothing. This is where you're happy to have your fat tires. On a 66%, 28.4 kilometers. That's quite nice. Well, no, I knew it wasn't paved. I thought it would be narrower though. I thought it was like really tight. Should be at the dam soon. We'll try to go a little past it along the Seymour Lake. The bears. What is yours?
20.
Still 100.
Yeah, we need 1,000 for that. The rest of the bike is not stupid.
Yeah.
But mine is also quite a bigger.
Yeah. And like I say, there's a 50-pound weight difference. And your bike is also lighter. It's probably 68 or less. Thank you. Go down here. Like a little beach. Wonder if we can get in there. I think you can access it if you sort of access it from that trail that we went on once that was locked off. That kind of leads somewhere to that area. What the hell is that? Well, it's obviously something with the crankshaft, with the pedals when you're turning. Well, I get that the tools coming in a couple days. Then I can take off the things and see if it needs grease in there. You still show 4 bars on your battery? Yeah, I have that too. Though the...
Once it goes to 99, I can drop it down.
Yeah.
Going from 100 to 1000, always keep it taken.
Mine drops instantly. The minute it's finished charging, it drops 5%. What was that? Huh? Squamish Creek, no water, picnic area. So here we are. Well, we can keep going. Unless you want to stop and eat first. Then it will be a left. The next left. We're coming up to Bear Island soon. We'll stop for a break and then we'll continue up the Spur 4 around Seymour Lake, which we've also never been on. It's 62%. She's still at 100%. But once hers starts dropping, it drops faster. Mine drops right away. The minute it's out of the charger, it's already dropped. Free dirt. Another hill. Best air you're ever gonna breathe. I think our turnoff is here. Bear Island. Hey. Hey. This is what I thought all of Spur 4 would be. And this is just the short route. Bear Island. So where are the bears? There's the bridge. Second bridge, so you get a better view of the dam. Yeah, it's great weather today. No rain, it was supposed to rain. I didn't go on this bridge last time. after the picnic area. So now we're going back up Bear Island Trail here to the Spur 4. Oh, I might have to push her bike up the last part because she has to get off. And I'll have to push it up myself so she doesn't hurt her knees. Hey. This is 3. Oh. Still breathing heavy. All right, I'll have to go down.
Okay.
Huh? Okay. Not into bed. I had to go in a pedal of 3 getting up there. What's this? Closed? What the hell? So you can't get in here? Oh, cute. I thought this was accessible. Huh. So I guess you can't get in here. This whole area around the lake, I guess, is off.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
Hmm. Too bad. I was hoping we could do that. Back down again. Hey. That's unfortunate. Thought you could get around the lake, but there's no access. So that leaves maybe a fisherman's trail and suicide branch. It's two trails I haven't been on. The suicide branch is a one-way. Fisherman's trail is closed. Percent battery. That's three bars now. And I guess we're back on the normal road. Hawk! Hawk! It just swooped down. It's a bit nicer view now. So I gotta take a picture of that. That's pretty good. Yeah, you missed it. Yeah, that's a nice shot. Look at this. Where does that go up on the right? Hi. Hi. There's that bike rack. Just room for one. Just in case you have to sleep overnight, you can lock the bike. Maybe if you're sleeping overnight, you can lock your bike there. Then you know it's safe. The bears won't steal it. Thank you. Yeah, the Spur 4 is nice, except of course you're on stones the whole way. But it did have some views that you wouldn't get here, like those drops on the left-hand side. But I expected it to be narrower. We could have gone up that right-hand side. It comes back down. To this trail, to the street. So it goes up and then comes down again. Probably you'll see the coming up here on the right, where you come out. At least my GPS is tracking us.
Stop making that noise. Not all the time.
I don't get it. Wonder if it's depending on how hard you're pushing. Like if you...
Yeah, maybe. Because sometimes when I go slow, uphill.
Yeah. It's like when you put pressure. Percent. So yours starts dropping faster once you get to 95. Yeah, I'm 36.1. We're almost the same. Wow. But I've gone down to three lights. Uh-huh. No. Where's that road? Still don't see it. I think we already passed it. Where? Uh-huh. All right. Bit of sun in there. Forty-seven. Thank you. 36% battery left, almost 39 kilometers. Four more kilometers to the entrance. So yeah, her bike is squeaking intermittently, not all the time. I think it's the amount of force on the pedals, the pedal assist level. When she has to push a bit harder, it starts squeaking. Standing and coasting for the last 5 minutes. Thank you. 45 kilometers an hour there. Battery 42.6 kilometers, still showing 3 bars on the battery. So I'd say it's probably more like 55% that I've got. I can hear you coming. Huh? It's the baby beaver bike. So if you pedal really easy, does it go away? Like if you increase the pedal assist and just go light on the chain. Battery 41% battery 40%, it's just dropping quick now, every 2 minutes. Now. Thank you.